Hi, my friends. Thank you for joining me. Why isn't this all over the news? I can't even find any reports in the UK where 202 people reported to AMS of a large fireball seen over there. This was yesterday. The Draconids Meteor Shower started yesterday. It runs from the 7th through the 11th. Here's one of the remarks. I have to translate it for you. It seemed to me that the light source was double. I was wearing glasses, so maybe the cause. I was watching my dogs in the garden, and it was the movement of the head of one of them that raised your head. Being quite close to Enzyme Runway and the Fallsburg helicopter base, which regularly operates at night flights, and also Baden-Baden Airport, our first thought of a plane. But the absence of noise made me lean towards observing a shooting star. I didn't have a watch, so I only have a rough idea of the time. When I got home, I joked that the little green men were coming. Now, this one said it had a very long tail that showed greenish white along the edges. This one here, too, said they were walking their dog, and it was impressive, and it was traveling very fast. This one here said the color was white. This one from France says it was blue and yellow. This phenomenon was the brightest that I had a chance to see. There was 6 photos submitted to AMS. That one not so impressive. That one probably is. This comes from Denmark, I believe. And another photo that was submitted to AMS. Yeah, I would say that was very impressive. Yeah, Stan corrected. These are from Germany. 202 reports of sightings, and you know there was a lot more that weren't probably never called in. People probably called the local news agencies. Why is this not all over the news? 18:30 Universal Time, that would have been 1:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time here in the U.S. Here's the time of the reports, and yeah, no one said they heard anything, it looks like. But very impressive. Like I said, we have the Draconids Meteor Shower that it's supposed to peak tonight, Friday evening. It's named after the dragon. That's the origin of its name. And that's because we're going through the debris of Comet P21 Jacobini Zinner. If I'm pronouncing it right, which I'm probably not. And here's an image of where you can look for in the night sky for this meteor shower where they're going to come from. You know, the ancients believed that seeing a comet was often a very bad omen. So tonight is supposedly the best night to watch the peak of the meteor shower. Yeah, what else is going to come with it? This debris. Sure seems like lately there has been definitely an uptick in fireballs and meteors, etc. And here on Cornell University, it says that in 1985, this comet, 21P, was the first comet visited by a spacecraft. It was diverted via a lunar gravity assist to pass through the plasma tail of the comet. NASA has an image of this comet. Yeah, the tail, though, doesn't really look that, you know, bright. It was first discovered on December 20th, 1900, and then rediscovered in 1913. Evidently, it passes through or by our Earth every 6.5 years. The last time it went by was in 2018. Each time this comet returns to the inner solar system, its nucleus spray ice and rock into space. This debris stream results in an annual meteor shower. the Draconids, which takes place each year in early October. Interesting, through the 11th, this meteor shower will be going on the dragon, and we definitely have a dragon of a year, but Satan knows his time is short. So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you very much, you guys, for watching. Please thumbs up my videos. That has a lot to do with the AI and how they send you the notifications, I guess, when I make videos. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.